While they're seen as a dying medium today, I'll always love DVDs. I'll never forget seeing displays of DVDs in stores. They're always so colorful and exciting to look at. I don't collect them, but sometimes, it can simply be interesting enough to see what's been released for our favorite shows, whether it be their covers, how they were released, or even promotions bundled in with the DVDs themselves. I remember I once got a SpongeBob Karate Island DVD with a demo disc for some Nick Arcade PC games bundled in. That was awesome. Anyone remember SpongeBob 3D Obstacle Odyssey? An absolute gem of a video game. As an American, most of my knowledge of DVDs are ones released here in America, but they're a global medium, and countless interesting releases exist from around the world. There are quite a few bizarre international DVDs, especially unlicensed ones. For example, take this bootleg Family Guy DVD from China. Looks mildly decent, right? Well, let's read the back of the box. Moot the Griffins. Peter, the big love-a-blow oof who always sees what's on his mind. Lois, the doting mother who can't figure out why Boar Baby ran coops trying to kill Hot. You get the idea. While obviously bootleg DVDs are funny and fascinating, there are some officially licensed DVDs from around the world that'll make your head spin, and that's what I'll be looking at today. In this video, I'll be taking a look at some of the craziest, wildest, most mind-blowing DVD oddities from around the world. I can guarantee you are not ready for some of the stuff we'll be looking at today. You'll look at most of these and wonder how any of this got released. It's all incredibly interesting. With all of that said, this is a look at bizarre international DVDs from around the world. Let's begin. From its premiere in 2003, Sonic X has always been a global hit, airing in over 50 countries around the world, and being a huge success with both Sonic fans and general audiences. Because of this, Sonic X has been dubbed into many languages, and countless DVDs have been released. Sonic X was originally planned to only last 2 seasons, and those original 52 episodes were released in Japan on these great DVD and VHS volume sets. Season 3 was later commissioned by 4Kids, as the show was such a success in America. Season 3 never aired on TV in Japan until just recently, over a decade after it was produced. Those Japanese DVDs are really great. They collect the entirety of the first 2 seasons of the anime, and each volume has unique cover art seldom seen elsewhere. Let me just say, there is a treasure trove of rare Sonic X artwork that was produced for promotional material, but then never released in full to the public. All of the covers for these Japanese DVDs are beautifully drawn and showcase events from the episodes included on each DVD. Take Volume 1, for example, which features many of the show's core cast. Volume 7 features art of Super Sonic, while Volume 9 has this awesome artwork of Sonic and Shadow that's just begging to be put on a poster. The French DVDs share a lot of covers with the Japanese releases, which is fitting as that dub is often considered to be the closest to the Japanese original. The opening is even a French cover of the Japanese opening, Sonic Drive. However, some of the French DVDs of Sonic X showcase even more rare artwork, such as these from Season 3 which showcase Sonic in various unique shoes. Check out this one of Sonic battling Bokun. I'd say the most competent DVD releases for Sonic X can be found in America, Japan, and France. Well, 4Kids did this weird thing with the American releases where the DVDs weren't separated by volumes, but instead seasons, leading to stuff like Sonic X, the complete 5th season, even though officially only 3 seasons were produced. But anyway, in terms of quality releases, these 3 countries are the places to go. The Spanish DVDs often use screenshots from episodes as their covers, which seems to imply they weren't given access to official art for use here? Strange. You'll notice a lot of international Sonic X DVDs have the Jetix logo on them, which is because Sonic X actually aired on that channel in European territories. If only that was the case in America, then we could have had Sonic X airing alongside shows such as Pooka or Get Ed. For European broadcasts of Sonic X, a different theme song was used in place of Gotta Go Fast. This alternate theme is a simple melody with singers that repeat Sonic X over and over again, and that's it. This intro was likely made for use in non-English speaking territories, as I doubt most dubbing companies would care to cover Gotta Go Fast. One interesting international change made to this particular opening can be found in the Hebrew dub of Sonic X. This dub seems to be pretty competent all things considered, having a flipped logo to fit the country's reading habits. But that wasn't the only change made. So at the end of the European opening, there's a shot where Sonic lands down surrounded by his friends, where he then gives a thumbs up and the intro ends. However, in the Hebrew opening, Sonic lands down, but then his animation is halted before he can strike the pose. When I first saw this, I thought, wow, that's odd, it must be a cultural thing. And turns out it is. Giving a thumbs up can be deemed offensive in some parts of the world. That must have been a nightmare for the dubbing companies. Do you know how many thumbs up Sonic gives in this show? If we're talking Sonic X openings though, no one can beat the folks over in Italy, who produced this overly catchy Italian Sonic X opening. It starts off a little weird, but the payoff is huge. Take a listen. Maybe it's just the musical tastes over there, or the fact that EDM techno music is my jam, but Italian dubs of shows always seem to have the best openings to me. For example, Don't Talk to Me If You're Not the Dragon Ball Z Italian theme. The GT opening isn't too bad either. It's so weird, like, even the My Little Pony Friendship is Magic opening bangs over there. Anyway, right, Sonic. Some DVDs from far-off territories can get pretty sketchy, such as this set from the Czech Republic. Seems fairly standard, right? Well, the first few volumes of these are pretty good-looking, but as early as Volume 5, you'll see the cover designers start to use artwork not sourced from Sonic X. I take it the designers simply ran out of unique artwork to use, and just grabbed whatever they could find. They made a ton of these volumes, as each one only contains 3 episodes. On Volume 9, they use artwork from Sonic Adventure 2. T'Challa is on Volume 15, despite the episodes included not featuring her. But things get really juicy on Volume 19. Yep, the cover solely focuses on Blaze, a character who isn't even in Sonic X. Those fake Season 4 leaks are finally a reality. There's Blaze on an official DVD release of Sonic X. She's also on Volume 23 along with Sonic and Amy. The episodes on these DVDs obviously do not feature Blaze, making these covers some pretty clear false advertising. This set was made by the Czech DVD company North Video. Their website is still up and has info on each of their releases, including their Sonic X DVDs. They even have preview videos for the DVDs on their YouTube account from 2010. I would love to grab some of these someday, especially the ones with Blaze on the cover. Any of these international DVDs would make for great additions to any collection, as they're so fascinating. It's interesting to see how different countries handle the releases of these shows. Here's a cool one. Official Sonic X VCDs from China, made by the company Mighty Media Co. Ltd. Apparently, these were made in very limited quantities, and were only available to be rented at Chinese Blockbuster locations around 2005. These contain both the Chinese and Japanese dubs for the episodes, and through the 39 discs, contain all 78 episodes. Most of the cover art featured is taken from the Japanese DVDs, with a few oddballs thrown in. A really interesting release, but good luck getting your hands on them. While all of these releases are interesting in their own right, I can't get over how much artwork was made for Sonic X and how much of it is unpreserved. There's so much out there, not to mention concept art, backgrounds, all that stuff. Hopefully someday, a complete Sonic X style guide will go up for sale and whoever finds it, buys it and preserves all of this. But until that day comes, we can all continue to use this same art of Sonic giving a thumbs up, unless it's deemed offensive in your country. There are few things in this world that bring as much unfiltered joy as the Deke Mario cartoons. And yet, it seems Nintendo wants absolutely nothing to do with them. Apart from the shows being available on services such as Netflix and, Steam? Nintendo never acknowledges these shows' existence. There's that awesome Mario Super Show-inspired fan game in the works, and while everyone was afraid that Nintendo would send the family working on that a big cease and desist, that would still be a win, because then Nintendo would finally show that they still care about our favorite Italian paisanos. Given Nintendo's utter lack of care for these series, you probably already know that the distribution and licensing for them is all kinds of whack, and you'd be correct. The Korean dub of the Super Mario Bros. Super Show is pretty interesting, as it features a great original intro, which is a lyrical take on the original Super Mario Bros. Theme. More interesting than that, though, is that the famous live-action segments from the American original have been completely redone and replaced with new segments featuring Korean actors. The Korean dubs of the Deke Sonic cartoons also featured dubbed openings, with the Korean Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog opening being a completely custom song. The Korean Sad AM opening is a cover of the original. I guess they knew that song was too good to change. Sonic, One interesting tidbit with the Korean dub of Sat AM is that over there was a shoe promotion with the show, and the commercial for said promotion thankfully can be found on YouTube. Interesting to know the show is popular enough over there to receive original content for promotions like this. Anyway, back to Mario. The company that's been distributing DVDs for the Mario cartoons for years in America is none other than Encircle. The company is a huge DVD manufacturer who releases budget sets for countless cartoons. Their DVDs all feature covers loosely based off of the episodes included on the DVD. Some covers look better than others, but many of them are very off-model. These DVDs are made on the cheap, but still. Then again, this same company has released several Deke Sonic DVDs featuring a blue arm Sonic, so I guess these really aren't that bad. This collection of art is featured on various international releases of the Mario cartoons, which also often use the art made for the old VHS releases. A majority of these VHS covers were done by Deke themselves, and some of the original art done for them still exists today. Deke produced three Mario cartoons over the course of their run with the series: the Super Mario Bros. Super Show, The Adventures of Super Mario Bros. 3, and Super Mario World. While technically different shows, some could look at these different cartoons as the same series, just being renamed as the Mario brand progressed. Because of this, the three shows are often confused in either name or artwork on these releases. Take this VHS from Argentina, for example. The title says Super Mario Bros. 3, but the back shows screenshots from Super Mario World. And the cover art is from the game Yoshi? How about this set from Spain? Most of the covers look fine, but Volume 4 bizarrely features artwork from Mario vs. Donkey Kong. How do these cover designers even source their artwork? Now, get a load of this one from Portugal. It includes the episodes of the Portuguese dub of, well, one of the Deke Mario cartoons. The cover doesn't really show us. Many of these international DVDs use random pieces of artwork that often don't represent what is actually on the disc. Such a mishmash of art, and yet it actually still looks kinda nice? I'm not entirely sure if this one is official, but it does have distribution info on the back, so maybe? Perhaps the license for these cartoons over in places like Portugal is very loose, and they'd rather want the covers to look appealing over accurate. Here's a Sonic DVD done by the same MD Movie Distribution Company. It features artwork from, let's see, Sonic Chronicles, the Mario and Sonic games, Sonic Advance. It's got both modern and classic Sonic on the same cover, and the title says Adventures of Sonic. And yet it has episodes of Sat AM on it. Well, they clearly tried. On the other hand, these Sonic DVDs of Russian origin are clearly Sat AM, in logo only. What is up with this artwork? It's a crazy mashup of classic and modern Sonic. How was this approved? Why didn't they just use stock art? Who designed these covers? Here's a pretty good looking one from Brazil. What's interesting about it? Well, look down at the corner. This one is done by Video Brinquedo, the same company that was behind such hit films as The Little Panda Fighter and Ratatouille. They began as a distribution company before nosediving into the realm of mockbusters. They also distributed DVDs for shows like Sonic X to Brazil. In my research, I found that a disturbing amount of Mario DVDs use this artwork, which is based off of artwork from the original Super Mario Bros., a far cry from the lovable plumber he is in these cartoons. While a bit confusing at times, some of these Mario cartoon covers do look quite nice. But for every well-made one, there are ones like this. It's widely known that the greatest DVD of all time is SpongeBob The Complete Second Season, but there are actually a lot more to SpongeBob DVDs than just that masterpiece. The early SpongeBob DVDs are such classics, aren't they? I'm not just talking about the season sets, though those are amazing. I'm talking ones like Lost at Sea, Tales from the Deep, Christmas, Home Sweet Pineapple, Absorbing Favorites, the list goes on and on. To this day, I still find these ones in stores. I guess they printed so many of these that stores still have them, but that's fine, I'll never get tired of seeing that Where's Gary DVD in stores. I had just about all of these when I was younger, and I loved every single second of them. And don't even get me started on the first 100 episodes DVD, the release of that was a historical event. It was such a great way to watch almost the entire series at that point, with tons of bonus features and man, even each disc had a unique menu. SpongeBob has had DVDs released in countless countries, for the many, many dubs of the show that exist. Let's talk about some of them. There exist two different dubs for SpongeBob in Japan. One cast dubbed the first three seasons of the show and the first movie, which was produced from 2002 to 2009, and aired on Nickelodeon in Japan. However, Nick Japan was taken off the air on September 30th, 2009, which briefly suspended production of the Japanese dub of SpongeBob. The show would continue to air on different networks in the country, and eventually a brand new dub featuring a new cast went into production, as they dubbed season 4 to present, including the second movie. Surprisingly, the new Japanese dub of SpongeBob features a brand new ending theme. The intro is just a Japanese cover of the English opening, but the Japanese hip-hop group Rip Slime produced a brand new ending theme for the show. SpongeBob, Along with that, starting in 2019, a second ending theme was made for the show as well. A majority of the DVDs produced for the Japanese dub of SpongeBob are simply Japanese versions of the American DVDs, with many releasing after Nick Japan as a channel went defunct, though they still use the Nickelodeon brand. This goes for many of the international DVDs for SpongeBob dubs. I mean, why change perfection? International dubs of American cartoons have always been so fascinating to me, whether it be changes made to the show itself, or even simple stuff like what channel they air on. Did you know that in certain territories, The Fairly Odd Parents airs on Jetix, now known as Disney XD? Fairly Odd Parents on Disney. While some international dubs opt to make an original opening for their localized show, it seems most SpongeBob dubs keep the original theme, and simply translate it into their language. This blew my mind when I was younger, get this. In certain dubs of SpongeBob SquarePants, an alternate opening is used. In the original intro, there are a few parts that show SpongeBob's name in English, which obviously would look weird in, say, a French dub of the show. Editing all of that custom text into your language could be tricky. So, for some of the dubs, Nickelodeon supplied this textless version of the intro, which replaces those parts with more generic stock animation. When the intro was redone in HD around the time of Season 9, they redid all of those international animations too to keep those dubs consistent as well. Even the stop-motion intro from Truth or Square had alternate versions produced. There are, however, some dubs that edit the English opening, with actual localized text. Some are even a mix of the two. There are many, many variations of the SpongeBob intro, considering just how many countries air the show. Now, given their amazing track record, I can't even imagine how amazing the Italian opening for SpongeBob must be. I mean, if they bust out such great songs for shows like Sonic X, what could they possibly do for one of the biggest cartoons of all time? In a surprising twist, it's just the international intro, but with no lyrics at all. This is one of the few dubs to do this, it's very interesting. But hey, check out that logo at the end of the original Italian opening. The show was actually simply called SpongeBob over there, and features a unique brighter logo showing off the main cast of characters. This carried over to some early DVD releases, a far departure from the American logo. This would, however, be changed for the HD intro, though it still lacks SquarePants. One interesting thing with certain SpongeBob dubs is how recent some of them are. For example, the show didn't officially start airing in Vietnam until 2016, with the dub consisting of episodes from seasons 3 and 4. Over in Bangladesh, the Bengali SpongeBob dub premiered on April 14th, 2019. That's so weird to think about. The early seasons of SpongeBob are brand new over there. In some countries, dubs for certain foreign shows are produced illegally, without the blessings of the show creators or the license holders. The best example of this are the Persian dubs of SpongeBob. They're known as Bob Esfanji. These dubs air in both Iran and Afghanistan, and are widely believed to be unofficial. There are at least 5 different Persian dubs of SpongeBob, all airing on different channels and made by different companies, with some even being exclusive to this video's main subject, DVDs. It's widely believed that most of, if not all, of these Persian dubs of SpongeBob are unlicensed, with no involvement from Nickelodeon. Why do people believe this? Well, while there are obvious things such as no mention of Nickelodeon anywhere in these dubs, the main reason to believe this is that these dubs often use custom music and sound effects, as if they had no resources from Nickelodeon and had to redo the entire audio tracks. And when they do use the original music, it's taken straight from the English episodes, with the original voices edited out poorly. And yes, this extends to even the opening of some of the dubs. Take a listen to the intro from the dub produced by the company Farzi. How strange is that? They also made some changes to the show itself to fit in with the country's regulations. One of the most controversial changes being editing clothes onto characters who wear bikinis like Sandy, as well as some of the background fish. Obviously, they did a very poor job at this. Because of this, Bikini Bottom was often censored as well. The name, however, was retained on most of the DVD releases of the show. Speaking of, they're as bootleg as you'd expect, but I personally find them to be immensely charming and funny. Someday, if it's ever possible, I would love to collect these Persian SpongeBob DVDs. I mean, just look at them. They slap together artwork from various sources, and give the DVDs names loosely based off of the episodes I assume are included. Some make sense, some don't. I'm personally a big fan of this one. coin. Who could forget the Fry Cook game? Or Stupid? Sandy's House? Bob and Big Prize? My personal favorite from this set has to be this one called Nowhere Is Our City. You tell him, Persian SpongeBob. I also really like this tiny Squidward that's next to the logo for seemingly no reason. How about this one that uses fan art of Gangsta SpongeBob? What episodes are even on this one? What about this one? What could this possibly contain? This one uses cover art from the game Plankton's Robotic Revenge. What episodes could be on this one? Well, as it turns out, this one doesn't contain any official SpongeBob episodes at all. Instead, you're looking at the cover of a bootleg SpongeBob film from Iran called SpongeBob in Tehran. Wait, what?
In Dostan.
That's right. In 2017, a 43-minute long SpongeBob special was produced and aired in Iran, made for that audience in mind. It's a trip. The film centers on SpongeBob and friends traveling to Tehran because they're out of the Krabby Patty's secret sauce, and the only way to make more is to get the secret formula, which for some reason is stored in Tehran. The gang then go off searching for a man who is said to hold all the answers they seek, and that man is... Lou? The Bargain Mart clerk? Alright. Despite being released in 2017, the animation looks straight out of those SpongeBob point-and-click PC games, with some additional stolen 2D animation, mostly from Sponge Out of Water. With that said, some of the writing here is actually pretty funny, though that may simply be due to how absurd it is. There's a side plot about Plankton also looking for the formula, so he too travels to the lands of Tehran. After some sightseeing, the gang meet up with a pantherfish apparently named Detective Fake, who claims he will help them find Lou. Then they go to a soccer game or something, and it just ends. The movie has no real conclusion, or at least the rips online don't. However, it has been said that airings on TV in Iran have the same abrupt conclusion. With that said, the movie is segmented into different parts, like episodes, so maybe there is more to it? There is this DVD called SpongeBob and Kabara. Maybe it's related? Is this a sequel? Somebody tell the A Day with SpongeBob SquarePants search team about this. We gotta know how the gang find the secret formula in Iran. In fact, this whole scenario reminds me a lot of A Day with SpongeBob, a bootleg but original SpongeBob movie released on DVD in limited quantities with no relation to Nickelodeon or Viacom, only this time it's real. The seemingly full movie is available to be watched on YouTube, uploaded by Extra Absorbent. It has full English subtitles, making it a bit easier to make sense of the story. If you're a SpongeBob fan or just a fan of weird animation, I highly recommend it. Interestingly, it seems this movie was made by the same team that produced a dub of the show, the one that airs on the channel Urib Puya, as the movie seems to share the same voice actors. This hasn't been confirmed, but it seems likely. If there are more than 43 minutes to this movie, I really hope it gets documented eventually. However, it would make sense if this truly is it and the movie just ends abruptly. It's an unlicensed movie made for a quick buck. What do the producers care if the story makes sense or has an ending? When I first discovered them, I was so intrigued by Persian bootleg DVDs. After looking up SpongeBob, I looked up ones for Sonic, and sure enough, they too look really bizarre, with tons of stolen official and fan artwork. Same goes for Mario. It seems bootleg DVDs featuring unlicensed dubs are a really big industry over there. While on the subject of Persian dubs, I just had to mention this. Remember how the Persian dub of SpongeBob uses a custom instrumental? Well, the Persian dub of Sonic X does the same thing, probably for the same reason of it likely being unofficial. It actually sounds really nice. How about the Persian intro for Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog? Wait, is that? Yep. The Persian dub of Adventures of Sonic the Hedgehog didn't even bother to recreate the original intro, instead using the instrumental of Katy Perry's song, Last Friday Night. At least the lyrics are original. Now, I would be but a fool if I did not use this video as an opportunity to talk about the Donkey Kong Country cartoon. We all know about this legendary show, but did you know it had a huge marketing push? It did, in Japan at least. The show was unreasonably popular over there, which led to many figures, plushes, and more being released. It's odd the show was so popular in Japan, as the series is French-Canadian in origin. With that said, DKC was a really big deal in France, where the show was animated. The series premiered in 1996, on a French TV block called The Planet of Donkey Kong, which aired on the channel French 2. Lots of material was made to promote the show in France, and it all makes for great entertainment nowadays. The Planet Donkey Kong block lasted for a while. It won an award and went under several names, such as DKTV. During commercial breaks on the block, the characters from the show were featured in various bizarre skits, referencing movies, pop culture. The block even featured music videos. Lots of stuff you wouldn't expect from Donkey Kong. All of these were only ever produced in French, and only aired in France. If there was ever a reason to learn French, understanding these would be it. If you thought the show itself was bizarre, you haven't seen anything yet. We're not in Congo Bongo anymore. Did you know that the DKC show is mo-capped? Well, it's pretty obvious given how odd the characters move, but some behind-the-scenes footage showcasing this has been released as well. DKC was actually a very impressive show for its time. In France, there was a Kellogg's promotion with Donkey Kong Country, where you could get one of six figures in specially marked boxes of Coco Pops. Of course, the promotion had a commercial to go with it.
Dans Choco Pops de Kellogg's, ils ont mis Donkey Kong! Et ça se passe comment au fond?
The US commercial for the Game Boy Color port of Donkey Kong Country also used models similar to the TV show, though DK has more intense fur textures. My absolute favorite piece of extraneous Donkey Kong Country material, though, is this video, in which Donkey Kong interviews Nancy Blair Griffin at Media Lab. This clip appears to be uploaded by Nancy herself, and the upload gives little context as to what this clip was made for, but maybe it's better that way.
See you here at Media Lab.
Hi.
Oh, excuse me, I'm carrying this phone around with me. Let me just put it up. Hang on a second. Oh, one, two, three. Presto change-o, no more banana phone.
Okay, so first off, that DK voice is pretty clearly not the original actor, though the animation here is pretty close to show quality. I assume this was made as an animation test for those DKTV segments or something, though I honestly don't want to know why this was made. It's much better without context.
What kind of stuff do they play?
Well, they like to play with action figures. They also like Tommy.
Tommy?
Yeah, from the Rugrats.
Oh, Tommy from the Rugrats. Could you scratch my back? You could do it with your left hand. Oh, that'll work. Oh, a little lower. Oh, a little bit to your left.
Media Lab, the company featured in this animation, was the studio behind the first season of the DKC series, as well as Planet Donkey Kong, and the various TV spots mentioned here. But despite their clear efforts, Media Lab filed for bankruptcy in the year 2000. The covers of the DVDs for the series are truly something. Earlier ones often featured screenshots from the episodes themselves, to varying results. Long after the show's run, however, Sony Pictures Home Entertainment would pick up the license for the series and release DVDs featuring, lovely artwork of our favorite apes. Surprisingly, as late as May 12, 2015, the complete first season of the cartoon was released on DVD in America, and in Germany, where the show was called Donkey Kong's Adventures, season 2 was released on DVD recently too. It's amazing to see that DVDs for this series are still being released today. It truly is timeless. And there you have it, a look at some fascinating DVDs of our favorite shows from around the world. You'll notice this video was about the dubs of these cartoons just as much as it was about the DVDs. And that's because it really is interesting to see how much these shows change for the different countries and cultures. It's important that dubbing companies, whether they be official or illegal, take great care in translating these beloved shows to other countries, because this is how those countries will perceive these shows. Some Iranian boy is going to grow up thinking this is a part of the SpongeBob series, and Italian children will grow up having great taste in music. And well, I just think that's all pretty neat. Stuff like this really inspires me to explore the world. own. You're telling me the SpongeBob theme is completely different in other countries? That's so interesting. One day, I'll have to find a way to import some of these DVDs. I need to see Nowhere Is Our City in person. Maybe those Blaze Sonic X DVDs too. I want to thank all of the brave DVD designers and dub producers from over the years for giving us all of this content. While some are better than others, it's clear a lot of passion goes into these to make sure these shows are the best they can be.